Let's go in this segment, we're going to talk about how to find square root of a number. We're going to look at an example of how do we find the square root of a number by using the Newton-Raphson method formula for finding roots of an equation. So we're going to look at an example here. So the way we derive the Newton-Raphson method formula, which is in the other segment, is that we start with the equation f of x is equal to x squared minus r. We're trying to find out what the square root of r is by simply solving the equation of x squared minus r equal to 0. And the Newton-Raphson method formula turns out to be, the recursive formula turns out to be of this nature, that x of I plus 1 is equal to 1 half x of I plus r divided by x of I. So what that means is that we have to start with some initial guess here of the value of r which is given to us, and then continue this process here till we find out that how acceptable our result for square root of r is. So let's take an example here. So let's suppose somebody tells me to find 62 square root of 62.41 by using this recursive formula. So let's see that how many iterations does it take for me to find the square root of r within a reasonable amount of accuracy. So what that means is that my x of I plus 1 in this case will be 1 half x of I plus 62.41 divided by x of I. I can clearly see now that this is a recursive formula here, that I put in some starting value of x of I get a new value of x of I. Then I put that back in here, and I keep on doing this process till I find out there's some refinement which has taken place, and that refinement should be acceptable to me. So let's go ahead and see that what I'm going to choose for my initial guess. That's the question which arises many a times. So in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep it simple. I'm going to say, hey, I'm going to choose the initial guess to be the number itself. Not a good choice of the square root of a number, but I'm going to say, hey, that's the best I can do. That I'm trying to find the square root of 62.41, I'm going to choose 62.41 as my initial value of initial guess of the square root. So what do I get from there? I'll get x1 is equal to x is equal to 1 half x0 plus 62.41 divided by x0. And since my initial guess which I chose is the number itself, I'm going to get something like this. And that value here turns out to be 31.705. So that's what I get as my first estimate of the square root of 62.41 by choosing 62.41 itself as my starting value. So let's go on and see that. Let's do one more iteration. Let's say I is equal to 2. I is equal to 1. I is equal to 1. I just found out what x1 is, which is 31.705. And I want to find x2. So if I put I equal to 1 into the Newton-Raphson method formula, which I just derived for the square root of a number, we 1 half x1 plus 62.41 divided by x1. And what is that? X1 is 31.705 plus 62.41 divided by 31.705. That's what I get there. And this number here turns out to be 16.83. So the first estimate, first guess which I made was 62.41 for my initial guess. Then the first iterative value which I got for the square root of the number is 31.705. And the next one which I'm getting is 16.83. So I've conducted some more iterations, and I want to just write those down. So I'm going to put I here. I'm going to put what x of I is. My initial guess was 62.41. Then I obtained 31.705, which we just calculated. And for the second iterative value, I got 16.83, which I calculated. And then the third iterative value, I'm getting 10.27. And that can be your homework. The fourth value I'm getting is 8.173, and that's also your homework. And the fifth value which I get is 7.905. And that's your homework also. So after five iterations, first iteration I get this, first two iterations I already done for you, and I would like you to do iteration number 3, 4, and 5, and that's what you get, 7.905. In fact, if you take 62.41 and you take the square root of that, that's the exact value. So even when we started with not such a good guess of the number itself for the square root of the number, after five iterations or so, you're finding out that you are extremely, you're close to the exact value of the square root of that particular number here. So that's how Newton-Raphson method formula is used to find the square root of a number. And as I said, the reason why you take such a plan to find out the square root of number on many of the supercomputers is because of the fact that this uses less computation time than having to take log of this, both log of the number and then taking the exponential of that number to be able to find the square root of a number. And in fact, the same kind of Newton-Raphson method formula can be derived for finding cube root of a number, fourth root of a number, and so on and so forth. And those can be made computationally more efficient than the regular ways of finding those roots of the root of a number, or square root of a number, or cube root of a number. And that's the end of this segment.